My daddy says I'm a special little guy.
I am a princess.
I am a prince.
Mum says I'm an angel sent down from the sky.
My daddy says I'm a special little soldier.
No one is as bold or tough as me.
Has my daddy told you?
One day when I'm older,
I can be a soldier.
Punch you in the face.
Take another picture of our pumpkin from this angle over here.
I know we oughtn't say this, but she's clearly cuter than her peer.
What a dear.
Honey, look at Mummy.
Try not to vomit on your brother.
Now smile for Mummy.
Smile for Mother.
I think she blinked.
Well, take another.
Have you seen what he can do?
Is that unusual for day two?
Is smiling early not a sign of an exceptional IQ?
She's just delightful.
So intuitive.
So insightful.
Mighty. Be a little brighter than the normal.
I know to say it's frightful for.
What on earth gives you that idea? I'm not listening to this. This is quackery.
But you're about to give birth.
Are you out of your mind?
Mrs. Wormwood, you're having a contraction.
I'm not having contractions. Contractions are for pregnant women. We're having babies. I'm having a stinking baby.
Every life I bring into this world restores my faith in humankind. Each newborn life a canvas yet unpainted. They're still unbroken skin, their uncorrupted minds. Every life is unbelievably unlikely. The chances of existence almost infinitely small. The most common thing in life is lies. And yet every single life, every new life is a miracle.
A girl.
Well, you mean my son is a girl?
I mean that your daughter is a girl.
Yeah, but the balloons, Doctor, I mean, the balloons, they say boy.
Mr. Wormwood, your wife has just given birth to a beautiful, healthy, happy little girl. She's perfect. This is fantastic news.
Why do bad things always happen to good people? Fine, upstanding citizens like you and me. Why, when we've done nothing wrong, should this disaster come along?
This horrible
miracle, weird-looking miracle,
hairy little stinky thing,
with no sign of a winky dink at all.
Every life is a miracle. Every life is a miracle. Every
to shut my pie hole. No one likes a smart-mouthed girl like me. Mum says I'm a good case for population control. Dad says I should watch more TV.
Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. So they say the subsequent fall was inevitable. They never stood a chance, they were written that way. innocent victims of their story. Like Romeo and Juliet, was written in the stars before they even met. That love and fate and a touch of stupidity would rob them of their hope of living happily. The endings are often a little bit gory. I wonder why they didn't just change their story. We're told we have to do what we're told, but surely sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty. Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, nothing will change. Even if you're little, you can do a lot. You mustn't let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let them get on top you, might as well be saying you think that it's okay, and that's not right. And if it's not right, you have to put it right. Of a bolt, there's a tiny revolt, the seed of a war in the creak of a floorboard. A storm can begin with the flap of a wing. The tiniest mite packs the mightiest sting. Every day starts with a tick of a clock. All escapes start with a click of a lock. If you're stuck in your story and want to get out, you don't have to cry, you don't have to shout. Cos if you're little, you can do a lot. You mustn't let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let them get on top, you won't change a thing. Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay, and that's not right. And if it's not right, you have to put it right. But nobody else is gonna put it right for me. Nobody but me is gonna change my story. Sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty.
What's going on to my head?
So you think you're able to survive this mess by being a prince or a princess? You will soon see there's no escaping tragedy. And even if you put in heaps of effort, you're just wasting energy. 'Cause your life as you know it is ancient history.
I have suffered in this jail, I've been trapped inside this cage for ages, this living hell. But if I try, I can remember that before my life had ended, before my happy days were over, before I first heard the pealing of the bell. I knew I was curious, so innocent I asked a thousand questions. But unless you want to suffer, listen up and I will teach you a thing or two.
For Zed.
Physical education. The Trunchbull's speciality.
Who are you?
We're prefects. We're here to take you to class.
So, we're going to start learning?
Oh, you'll start learning, all right.
Great! I already know the alphabet.
You don't know the alphabet until we learn you the alphabet.
And so you think you're able to survive this mess by being a prince or a princess? You will soon see there's no escaping tragedy. Before my
hear what we said?
I have become aware that some of you are not yet in class. Correct
this.
You have five seconds to
comply. C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X,
three.
Why?
Two.
What happened to Matilda inside, quick?
One.
Just you wait for Phys Ed.
An exception to the rules.
In my school. Look at my trophies.
See how my trophies gleam in the sunlight. See how they shine. What do you think it took to become English hammer throwing champion 1959? Do you think in that moment, when my big moment came, that I treated the rules with casual disdain? Well, like hell. As I stepped up to the circle, did I change my plan? What? As I chalked up my palms, did I wave my hands? I did not. As I started my spin, did I look at the view? Did I drift off and dream for a minute or two? Do you think I faltered or amended my rotation? Do you think I altered my intended elevation? As the hammer took off, did I change my grunt from the grunt I had practiced for many a month? Not a jot, nor a dot, did I stray from the plot? Not a detail of my throw was adjusted or forgotten. Not even when the hammer left my hands and sailed high up, up above the stands. Did I let myself go? No. No, 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 no.
If you want to throw the hammer for your country, you have to stay inside the circle all the time. If you want to make the team, you don't need happiness or self-esteem. You just need to keep your feet inside the line. Sing, children. 2, 3, 4.
If you want to throw the hammer,
in altum est meditum,
you have to stay inside the circle
all the time. And if you want to teach success, you don't use sympathy or
tenderness.
You have to force the little squids to toe the line. Sing, Jenny!
If you want to throw the hammer for your country, you have to stay inside.
A ball, so learn to throw it. Find the belly line and toe it. And always keep your feet inside the line. Now get out. Eat.
Can't.
Eat.
Surely can't.
Eat.
Why did it slide?
Eat.
A single slice, or even two, Bruce. Might have been nice, but even you, Bruce, have to admit, between you and it, there's not a lot of difference in size. You can,
surely can,
you are the man, Bruce. He might explode, he's quite elastic. He's going to blow, make him stop, he's fantastic. Look at him go,
I can't watch, I think it affects.
This must confirm, Bruce, what we all suspected. You have a word, Bruce, or maybe you're large.
Bruce,
with every swallow you are tight. properly come to use. No excuse, Bruce. Let's have your belt, I think you'll want your trousers loose. Oh, stuff it in.
Bruce!
You're almost finished.
Bruce!
Your fit is in, whatever you do, just don't give in.
Bruce!
Don't let her win. Come on, Bruce, be our hero. Cover yourself in shoulder glory.
Bruce!
To never again be subject to abuse, for your immense caboose. To call the truce, Bruce. Just one more bite and you're completely cooked to go.